Hi everybody, Joey here again and welcome back. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to build an LED light for your aquarium that's both cheap and very easy to build. However, it's extremely capable of also growing plants in your aquarium, which is a highly requested project from you guys for me. Now, it shouldn't go without saying that I've already have a couple of light builds on this channel from the past that are also capable of growing plants in your aquarium. So if you want to check those out as well and see which one best suits your capabilities and budgets, be sure to do so. So in last week's video, it was the final video to my planted tank build series. And if you remember the setup or the equipment video, I showed you all of the equipment that I purchased for the aquarium, and a lot of this equipment was things I've been wanting to try for a long while. What I said in that video was most important though. I was going to start with these products and then systematically replace them with do-it-yourself alternatives. So today we're starting from the top and replacing the light. If you remember, I started off with a Kessel A360WE LED light. Now this is a fantastic light, however, it's a $400 light. $500 if you want the controller, and almost close to $600 if you want the gooseneck and extender. That adds up fast. The light I'm going to show you only costs between $50 and $60, and then additional costs if you want to build a canopy or what have you. Now I'm not saying that this light is going to replace all of the Kessel lights. I don't know if it can, I've only been able to test it on a few aquariums. But what I am saying is that it has completely replaced the Kessel on my aquarium. So in this video, I'm going to show you not only how to build it, but how to size it to your tank, show you what it's capable of. Then I also want to try it on my goldfish aquarium, as well as my Asian arowana tank. Because this type of light is so cheap and easy to make that it doesn't have to be used on a planted aquarium, you could use it on any aquarium. Before we begin though, take a look at this. Which one do you think is the Kessel light, and which one is the do-it-yourself alternative? Interesting, right? Well, what I wanted to do for this video is simple. I wanted to be able to show you what this light is potentially capable of on your aquariums. And to do so, I gotta show you plant growth with the light installed. However, I've been testing this specific light sporadically on my planted aquarium. Meaning that for a couple weeks I would run it and then switch it back to the Kessel, and then for a few more weeks I would run it and switch it back to the Kessel. But for this video, I decided I'm going to cut out all of the plants and shrink it down to only about 2 inches of plants, toss the new do-it-yourself light on it, and then in a few weeks come back and show you the progression. However, you guys have been hounding me to do this light, but these builds take a lot of time, especially if I want to be able to show you these comparisons and results. With that said though, the new Nano Aquarium build that you guys are going to see shortly has been running this do-it-yourself light exclusively, just on a much smaller size. And the growth has been stunning. The plants are growing much faster, and I have no problems with that tank at all. That is a build that is completely do-it-yourself though. However, like I said, you'll see that shortly. So as mentioned, I want to be able to chop out all the plants and show you a comparison, but we're going to air this video a lot sooner than before. But what I discovered and what I thought was happening with this Rotala that I chopped down is that when I cut it down, I exposed a ton of plants that were dying. Nothing but stems and roots left after I cut it away. So when we eventually do an update on this tank, it'll be extremely interesting to see what happens. So let's just jump right into the light. I decided that I could build almost any kind of light that I want, but there's a lot of things that come into play when I have to decide on which videos I want to show you. One, it has to be cost effective. I know a lot of you guys want to save money. I can't do these extremely large builds that put them way out of reality and touch for you guys. I also have to make sure that it's not that difficult, because I truly want many of you to be able to take advantage of a lot of these do-it-yourself projects, which in turn probably keep you in the hobby a lot longer. So for this build, I decided we're going to repurpose some existing lights. Now apparently, floodlights have been used in the planted aquarium hobby for some time now. Unbeknownst to me, because the planted aquarium hobby is something that I wasn't into until recently. With that said, there's been mixed reviews. A lot of people are having success and some are not. Today I'm going to share my success story. I jumped on Amazon and I noticed that there was these really nice looking LED floodlights. They came with brackets and LED chips that are very similar to the Kessel. They came in 6,000 Kelvins, which is the color temperature of the light, meaning that it's really close to sunlight. And it has a waterproof rating of IP65, meaning that you can splash water all over these and it's gonna have no impact on its performance. It doesn't make it waterproof, but it certainly adds a massive layer of protection when putting something like this above your tank. I also chose these because it gives me a spotlight effect, or more of a pendant look. Basically a small light that can hang directly over your tank. I also noticed that they came in many different wattages, 60 watt, 30 watt, and 15 watt. the 60 watt only costing $52, the 30 watt only costing $28, and finally the 15 watt only costing $18. At this price, it's really hard not to want to try them out. The ones I got were made by Golsan, but there's a tremendous amount of brands out there, and not all of them are going to give you the same results that I got. With that said, you don't have to get the same brand I got. The thing with these, though, is they don't come with a plug, so this is where the do-it-yourself comes into play. We're not only repurposing this floodlight to be an aquarium light, but we also need to incorporate some do-it-yourself. So I picked up some cheap grounded extension cords for only $1 each on Amazon as well, and chopped off the receptacle portion. Use a razor and some wire strippers to expose the wire, and then connected them to the LED light as needed. Now the LED lights will typically tell you which wire is which, and you'll be able to match those up to the extension cord. I then took some shrink tape and cleaned up the wires to make it a little bit prettier. Now the light was ready to go. However, I have to admit that before I actually wired this up, I installed the light into the canopy that I built for the tank, and then ran the wires through the canopy, followed by wiring it. So we need to take a step back and talk about the canopy. Now, of course, if you don't want to build a canopy for your aquarium, you can just mount these over your tank somehow with something like a gooseneck. For example, the Kessel light does come with a gooseneck, and this is kind of what it looks like if you were to put a 30 watt LED on it. However, you can also jump on Amazon and pick up goosenecks for as little as $5 or $6. For me, I wanted to build a canopy system and have the light built into it. I also wanted it suspended from the ceiling and have a pulley system on it. But I didn't have time for all of that because I'm putting this video out 3 weeks than it was supposed to come out. So I cut some spare plywood up that I had. In fact, it was the wood that I had left over from the office aquarium shelf. And I built a small box out of it. Now, the size of the box was the dimensions of the actual stand. And if you remember on the stand is actually slightly bigger than the aquarium itself. And I did this on purpose because I knew that one day I'm going to want to build a canopy, and I want the canopy to also be slightly bigger than the aquarium, and it would look more uniform if the stand was as well. Once I built the wooden box, I stained it a few times to match the color of the stand with stain that I had left over from the stand, and then moved on to installing the light. Now, the canopy technically didn't really cost me anything because it was scrap wood, and you don't have to do this. You can install this however you want, but if you already have an existing canopy on your aquarium, this will be really easy to install. Now again, this video is coming out a few weeks earlier than I had anticipated, and I didn't have a lot of mounting equipment. What I decided to do was take some spare nuts and bolts that I had and mount the light directly into the center of the canopy. Now, if you notice, it has a little swing arm and I can direct the light wherever I want it to go. As for hanging it, I had a few spare brackets, and then I had some garage door wires and connection pieces that I used to kind of hold up the light. Now this actually looks pretty horrible, but it's what I had at the time. I do plan on upgrading all of this in the near future, but just for the sake of getting this video out, this is all temporary. I then ran the wire up through my ceiling and drilled a hole directly through my floor support and ran the wire through it. The light is now suspended exactly the same height as the Kessel light is. Now, before I built this and suspended it, obviously I just took the LED light out and clipped it onto the gooseneck of the Kessel light, so I was able to test it and take it off easily. With the light suspended though, it now makes it more difficult to get in and out of your aquarium, or so it might look. I can easily take this off, or I can just push it out of the way. Again, just a temporary solution to get it done. So now let's talk about the light itself. As I said, this light isn't necessarily going to replace the Kessel as a whole, but it certainly did the same thing the Kessel could on this tank. And as I already said, I'm getting amazing results with my nano aquarium. Again, you'll see all of this progression in the weeks to come. So how bright is this light and what is it capable of? Well, I don't have a power meter. However, we can kind of measure it with a cheap lux meter, which lux means basically how much visible light is coming out of it, or how bright is it? And to be honest, they are actually pretty similar. This 60 watt LED is on par with the Kessel light turned up to 70%, which is what I ran it over this tank anyway. The next thing you'll notice is that the do-it-yourself version doesn't shimmer or create as much shimmer as the Kessel does. Why? Well, it's because of the way the floodlights are designed. The floodlights are designed to light up as much light in front of it as possible, so the light is spread out a lot more, which is kind of beneficial to light up more of your aquarium. But as for penetration, the Kessel is designed to penetrate deeper water, so you get less shimmer, but I also am not sure how deep of an aquarium this will be able to handle. With water 20 inches deep, it's no problem at all, so I can't see it being too much more of a problem in regularly sized tanks that are 24 inches tall. You also can't dim this light like you can on the castle. However, just because you can't dim it doesn't mean you can't add some sort of a diffuser. Which brings up the next point, is that you can't change the color of the light like you can on the castle. So like I said, this light is at 6,000 Kelvin rating, whereas the castle has a lot more flexibility in what color spectrum you can have. Although the castle was set to 6,000 anyway. The benefit to the alternative, the do-it-yourself version here, is that it's really cheap and really easy to build. Obviously, just find a floodlight you like, and that's going to be the color spectrum you need, and the wattage you require, and wire up an extension cord to it. It's really that simple, so anybody can do this. Now, to size lighting, a lot of the times watts per gallon doesn't work, but I'm running it at 2 watts per gallon, and same with the nano aquarium, and I'm getting fantastic results. Also on the 60 watt version, it's going to light up a 2x2 area with ease. So basically, for every 2 feet of aquarium you have, you'll need one of these. Now obviously this isn't an LED light that's going to work on everybody's situation, and especially if you have a massively long tank and you thought you're going to be able to light it for 50 bucks. This video is to show you what I've been able to replace on this aquarium. Now maybe you just want a nice bright solution for your aquariums using an LED light that is kind of like a pendant style and is cheap and easy to set up. So let's take a look at what this will look like if it were to replace the lighting on this tank. Now I was trying out different lights on this tank, and right now it has a 40 watt LED strip on it that's 4 feet long. Now when we switch it over to a 15 watt version, you can see what just a single 15 watt version of this can do. Now let's take a look at the Asian Arowana Aquarium. If you remember, we also have do-it-yourself lighting above that in pendant style, and each one of them have LED bulbs, and they evenly light up the tank. But if we put a 15 watt version over this tank, it looks pretty great as well. Now, because I'm not growing plants in these, I'm not going to need a lot of these LEDs on this tank. Maybe just 2 on this tank and 2 on that tank. Now, this isn't the end all of do-it-yourself aquarium lights that'll grow aquarium plants. I do have a lot of plans to do future builds on more methods of building your own lights for your planted aquarium. However, since that light is now replaced, it's now time to move on to something else, and the next thing that I want to replace on the planted aquarium is a diffuser. So as mentioned, in the weeks to come, you're going to see a lot of different videos for planted aquariums. However, I will be mixing in some other do-it-yourself projects, especially this do-it-yourself filter that I'm working on that I'm really excited to show you, and you'll see that in the coming weeks as well. Anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed today's video. I'd also like to thank you for watching, and if you join me next Sunday, I'll have a new do-it-yourself project for you.